So it's time to meet the boxers. Boxing out of the blue corner, weighing in at 9 stone, 12 pounds and 2 ounces, in this, her 11th professional contest, she's wearing the red and white trunks. She hails from the Bushka in Bosnia and Herzegovina. It's Katarina Vistica! And her opponent standing across the ring, boxing out of the red corner, weighing in at 9 stone, 6 pounds and 12 ounces, in this, her fourth professional contest, and has a career consisting of 3 victories to date. She's wearing the black and gold trunks. She hails from Liverpool, England. It's Natasha Jonas.
Okay, here we go. Welcome to the Black Flash promotion show from the new Oldham Leisure Centre. We have Miss GB, Natasha Jonas, in the ring against Katarina Vistic. And I'm joined by another superstar, Stacey Copeland. Good to see you, Stacey.
Yeah, good to see you too. Great to be here.
It's great having Natasha on this show. It really is.
Yeah, absolutely. It's great for people to see her live. You know, a lot of the...
Oh, and straight away, a lovely counter, left hand from that southpaw stance.
From sparring with Tasha, I can honestly say she hits above her weight, you know, like you wouldn't.
Yeah.
She's got real, real power in her punches, and technically she's just very, very, very good.
Now, obviously, there's no doubt about how amazing her amateur career is, but she's taken to the pros like a duck to water as well.
Definitely. And Tasha's someone who likes to be very precise with the shots. She likes to select, you know, the right shot at the right time. She's quite meticulous about, you know, she doesn't just throw for the sake of it. She'll pick her shots well, and when she lands, she lands clean, and you can see it has devastating impact.
Absolutely, and she's brought you know, all of Gallagher's gym out with her. You know, they've all come to support. They're a good family. You know, gym. Anthony Crawler in the corner there, of course, with Joe Gallagher.
I think it's a great testament to the whole gym, really, and Joe, that, you know, they all support each other like they do. I think it's brilliant.
Absolutely. And Natasha really does back it up in the ring as well. I mean, just some of the precision on some of these shots and the weight behind them.
Tasha's got really, really long leverage, and I know, again, from sparring with her, that, you know, she can look out of range and suddenly she isn't. You know, she sets it up well with the jab, and then she comes in with that long backhand, either to the body or to the head.
I don't even see it coming. That right out off the front leg. That was a great shot, and I like the way she gets out of range as well. So she's always aware of what's coming back.
Yeah, she's. As I said to you earlier, I didn't see this girl lasting.
No.
Very long in this
She's
fight.
Actually done well to last so far.
Absolutely.
Because that first shot she caught her with a raking shot straight down the middle.
Yeah. She's in 8 ounce gloves tonight as well, which makes a difference. Joe was saying it's just been changed for women now, where the lower weights are in the 8 ounce gloves. So it's the first time she's worn those, so it's...
Yeah, well, an impressive
not
first round.
To the opponent.
No, not helpful to her at all. But, you know, to be fair to Katarina Vistica, you know, she's done well there, because she could have just escaped out the fire exit there.
Technically, she was always one of the best, you know, if not the best, technical boxer on the GB programme, you know.
Yeah.
She's boxed at world level for many years now.
Yeah.
Very, very experienced, so...
Well, you make a great point. I mean, having boxed on world level already for a number of years, she's got a real pedigree behind her, and it's almost like we should expect this, really, sort of fantastic
Absolutely,
performance from her, shouldn't
because
we?
She will have seen all different types of styles and opponents in front of her that she's had to figure out a way to beat her many, many times before, so, and obviously it's no different in the pros. I think she'll be ready next year for a big step up.
Yeah, yeah. And I've got a feeling the tougher the competition gets, the more... Oh, that's a good shot there. Just caught her off balance.
Three,
flash knockdown.
Four,
but again, it's speed
five,
and it's timing.
Six,
more, that one was more timing,
seven,
wasn't it?
Yeah.
Eight.
Joe calling for shots, big shots up into the pit there. And she's got that steely, sort of vicious look on her face.
Oh,
there.
Yeah,
she's got spiteful
focused,
punches, hasn't she?
Very, very focused. This is just a top class boxer. See, what she does really well is sort of edges in. Finds a range, sets it up with the jab, and then comes in with it. But she does vary that backhand.
Yeah.
Like I say, in sparring, you don't know what's going to come after that jab. Sometimes it's a straight left. Sometimes it's to the body. You just don't know what's coming.
Yeah. No, not down there. Yeah, feet are getting tangled a little bit. I love
Tasha's
the way.
Really good at getting a foot on the outside. Mm. You know.
I love the way she's using that lead arm. Oh, he stopped it. Stopped it. Referee stopped it. To be fair, Katrina's face is starting to mark up badly.
I think the only thing that was going to happen there is she was going to get even more hurt, wasn't she?
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
And like Tasha was saying before this one, she was hoping for a step up. I don't necessarily think she. No disrespect to Katrina, but obviously she didn't get a step up tonight. But I think next year that's definitely what she'll be looking for, is it a step up to, you know, because it helps her show more of her repertoire then as well, doesn't it?
As they say in boxing, though, you've got to deal with what's in front of you, and she dealt with what was in front of her in a concussive fashion, really.
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, the stoppages have been brutal, you know, in every case.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
And, you know, she's only getting better and better, obviously, because you get the benefit of each camp as well as the actual fight that you're building up to. So
yeah,
next year, definitely, she'll be ready for a step up. And, you know, someone's got to start putting pressure on these other fighters who are around about the weights she's at, obviously one of them being Katie Taylor, but also Chantel Cameron, and
you
know, there's a lot of Delphine Persoon. There's a lot at the world level who are not getting spoken about because, you know, rightly, understandably so, Katie Taylor's taking a lot of the media exposure. But there's going to be some really, really exciting rivalries.
And I can't wait to see him, to be honest with you. To be honest, I love it when I watch you fight because I can see that steely intensity on your face. I see the same look in Natasha Jonas's eyes, and it's great to watch.
Absolutely.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, our timekeeper at ringside records an official time of 1 minute and 21 seconds of round 2 as the end of the contest. As a result of our referee, Mr. Mark Lyson, stopping the contest, therefore your winner from Liverpool is Natasha Jonas!
Great performance there by Natasha Jonas, and really great to see her on one of these small hall shows.
Yeah, I think it's great for Black Flash Promotions to, you know, to have Tasha on the show. It's, I think it's been a brilliant, you know, brilliant addition to the card for tonight. And it was great to have it as a main event as well.
Absolutely, and you know what? You know, we've had you on these shows as well, now Natasha. I mean, it's great that women's boxing is getting its rightful place on these shows.
Yeah, definitely, it's great. I think it's brilliant. It's something we're going to see more and more as well. And like I say, the thing we need next now is these big rivalries, and that's what's going to come next year, definitely.
Okay, listen, we're here with Miss GB, Natasha Jonas. And Natasha, what an impressive performance there. Firstly, give me your initial thoughts.
You know, I'm always looking to, you know, learn something in every fight. I didn't get the round in that one, but, you know, I was getting caught with a few backhands, the head's gone in. So, you know, it's an experience, and I've worked my way through it and still getting off the shots that I wanted and shots that we tried in the changing room, so I'm happy about that.
Now, obviously, your amateur pedigree goes before you, but you've taken to the professional ranks like a duck to water. I said that in commentary, but you really have, haven't you?
Well, I don't know. You know, it's a different game. You know, I'm still learning, as I say, and you're just trying to get experience, you know, for the big fights that are down the line.
What Stacey and I noticed as well there is that, you know, you're very friendly and amenable out of the ring, but when you're in there, it's all business, and you actually throw with a lot of spiteful intent, I can tell on your face.
I think one of me pluses as an amateur was always being me power, and sometimes it didn't quite suit me as an amateur because, you know, at the time it was point scoring, so I think for the professionals it suits me to just stay there, but, you know, plant my feet a bit more and let the power go, and, you know, I think we're seeing the best of me now.
And it's a real testament to your gym that, you know, you've all come out here. We've got Anthony Crawler, the Smiths, you know, Marcus, Scotty Cardle, you know, all the lads have come out to support you. It's a real testament to the family feel at your gym, isn't it?
Yeah, you know, we're keeping a lot of known each other for some short but some a long time, but we, you know, it's a home away from home. You spend all day in the gym with the lads training and going through it, so, you know, you're like, they're like the other family, they're like we big brothers.
Yeah. Now, obviously, it was a small old show tonight, you know, but there's going to be some massive things for you, you know, in 2018, isn't there?
Yeah, hopefully. You know, I wanted to finish the year with a bang. You know, I've got 4 professional fights under my belt, and hopefully next year I'll get a lot more. Yeah. But, you know, yeah, there's big fights out there. There's people in my weight, you know, the division's buzzing.
Yeah.
And, you know, hopefully I can be a part of that.
And, of course, you know, I was in their commentary there with Stacey Copeland as well, another pioneer of women's boxing. You know, you guys are really on a cusp of a wave here, aren't you? And female boxing is really in a strong apex now, isn't it?
It is. It's good that, you know, we're getting promoted. We're getting the fights that we need, and you know, domestic rivalries do build like a good foundation, and people like to get behind one or the other, you know, and it's good to see that. But I think as women boxers, we always knew that once people saw it at its highest level, you know, at its elite level, that people would enjoy it and would support it, and it was just getting it out there, and now we're here and we're here to stay, and hopefully we're going to put on more big shows and more big nights.
Well, congratulations on a brilliant performance. It's so good to see you on the Black Flash show on this promotion. It's been brilliant. And anything you want to say in a final note?
Yeah, just, you know, massive thank you to Black Flash for having me, because they didn't have to do that, and you know I'm not part of their brand as such, but you know, I appreciate you guys putting me on the show, and I thank you, and hopefully I can be back soon.
Watch out for Natasha Jonas. 2018 is going to be a big year for her. Thank you so much. Cheers.